Celtic world has more than its share of the supernatural, legends, and myth, which sometimes cross the line into reality. I tell those tales here on Dark Celtic History. The Witches of Culross. Now, better known for its appearance in the hit show Outlander, this peaceful 17th century village of Culross has a dark past. This little sleepy Scottish hamlet took their condemnation of witches and criminals very seriously back in the 18th century. Witches were imprisoned and tortured in the townhouse, all that before being burned at the stake. And then petty criminals were branded for life, S-shaped courtroom key, S for sinner, and forced into hard labor to repay for their sins. Now within the eerie ways and streets of this town, you may encounter the young and elegantly dressed ghost of Mary Erskine, holding a banquet of lavender as she admires the palace garden, which her family purchased in the early 18th century. Mary lived a privileged life of relative luxury and safety for her times. Yet when the fervor over witches began, she placed herself at the forefront, a place that she probably should have just stayed away from, in order to bring swift justice to those that did the devil's bidding. Now, she was known to ramp up public support for her condemnations of suspected witches and criminals, and this before the truth of their crimes were even brought out in a court of law. Now, being of status in the town, she held some sway over the decisions a small town court could make, for almost everyone held some allegiance or owed their livelihood to her husband and father. So for a few years, her spiteful and vengeful heart persecuted many who lived in and around Culross, and she earned the fearful respect of the people of Culross. Now, then one fateful day, she heard a rumor that a woman was found naked in a field outside of town. Oh, the shame. The people who found her said she was drunk, babbling, and was possessed by the devil. Well, of course, without even looking into the matter, she advised the courts to condemn her as a witch. If she had anything to do with the biddings of the devil, she needed to burn at the stake. Now later that day, as the smoke from the funeral pyre was seen billowing over the town, the front door of her estate house burst open, and her husband ran in and informed her that her sister Margaret was just burned as a witch. Now, Mary Erskine, she was distraught, just destroyed, realizing that her actions, that her petty vengeance is what caused the death of her sister, broke her heart. Now Mary Erskine spent the rest of her days as a recluse, shut off from the world, too ashamed of what she had done. She is said to have prayed every day for God to punish her, or to give her some way to make amends for what she had done. Now this is why she holds a banquet of lavender as she admires her palace garden, for this is the place her sister's remains were buried, and the funeral she lives out over and over in her own personal hell.